三宝。
With three treasures, four new now receivers.
大人的一生中有许多值得庆贺的事情，但却有更多无价且必须要全力以赴来追求的东西。
There are many things in life worth celebrating. However, there are even more priceless things worth pursuing with all our efforts.
2500多年前，当释迦牟尼佛仍是王子时，亲眼目睹了人世间之生老病死。他告诉自己，一定要找到一条永恒之路。于是他放弃了王位及荣华富贵，四处去找寻名师及永久解脱的法门。后来燃灯古佛为他受记，最后他修成了正果，也留下了许多的经典，引导众生开悟正果。
About 2,500 years ago, when Sakyamuni Buddha was still a prince, he witnessed the four sufferings of life, birth, old age, sickness and death. He told himself, I've got to find the way that leads to eternity. Thus,He gave up his throne and fortune in search for an enlightening master and a way to eternal liberation. Later, he was initiated by Dipankara Buddha and eventually reached Buddhahood. Sakyamuni Buddha's teachings were collected by his disciples as sutras.The large collection of sutras have continued to guide sentient beings even till this day.
在一般人的思维里，极有价值、罕有、又很不容易得到的东西，而且是人类所一直在追求的，我们才会称之为宝。今天您在上天的恩典及诸佛菩萨的祝福下求了道，得了三宝。得道就是当初佛陀及无往经来的修行者宗教家倾毕生之力所追寻的永恒之路。过去因为天时未至，道是单传独授，得道者稀，修行者常有踏破铁鞋无觅处之憾。如今上天慈悲大开普度，得道者众，求道者可说是得来全不费功夫。虽然得道容易，也是自己累世佛缘根基深厚，祖上有德所致，所以当您求完道时，大家都给您道喜。
Generally, we call a precious, valuable, and rare item which is highly sought after as a treasure. Today, because of the grace of heaven and the blessings from all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas,You have received Dao and the three treasures. Dao is the way to eternity that Sakyamuni Buddha, countless cultivators, and religious people had been searching all their lives. Before 1930, Dao was transmitted on a one-to-one basis.An enlightening master could only transmit Dao to a one-qualified individual because the timing for universal Dao transmission was not ripe. The number of people receiving Dao were scarce due to the lack of opportunity to meet with an enlightening master and receive Dao. What a pity! Because of the grace of heaven, now is the time for universal Tao transmission, and therefore, many people had the opportunity to receive Tao. Although it may seem relatively easy to receive Tao, receiving Tao is actually based on your affinity with Buddhas, your deep spiritual foundation, and the beneficence of your ancestors. Thus, after you have received Tao, everybody would express their heartfelt joy and congratulate you.
依照三宝来修行的话，可以帮助我们：第一，跳脱生死轮回；第二，净化我们的业力，改变命运；最后，返回天上的不家乡。
Practicing these three treasures can truly help us in the following ways. 1. Transcending the cycle of life and death. 2. Cleansing our karma, changing our destiny, and eventually returning to our heavenly home.
一般的人由于业力的牵引，不得不再度来到这世界上，每来一次就会造些业。漫漫的人生路上，总是有着诸多的不如意、抱怨、忧愁、烦恼、病痛等。面对命运的枷锁与生死的轮回，却不知所措，更无法跳脱出来，实属无奈。
Because most people's destiny are led by their karma, they have to go through the cycle of life and death repeatedly without choice. Each cycle of life and death would accumulate some karma, good and bad. Therefore, their long journey of life would be filled with different kinds of complaints, worries, annoyances, sickness, and sufferings. Life's journey is never what we expected. Most people are imprisoned by fate and trapped in the cycle of life and death. They feel helpless because they failed to find a way to become liberated.
我们人的身体只是灵性暂时居住的房子，当生命旅程结束时，灵性会脱离身体进入另外一个世界，而求道时得到的三宝就是回天的凭证，这也是人生中最重要的一件事。以下事项是需要您放在心上的，一，不要忘记三宝，也不可以泄露三宝；二，不反倒败德；三，多了愿，多行功立德。如此，我们才可以回天上的故家乡。
Our physical body is a temporary home for our soul.When the journey of our life comes to an end, our soul will leave the body and enter another world. The three treasures you have received are the token for returning to the heavenly home. They are the most important things in our lives. The following are the three main points that you need to keep in mind.1. Do not forget and disclose the three treasures. 2. Do not do anything illegal, immoral, or harmful to yourself and others. 3. Do as much as you can to fulfill your vows and accumulate merits and virtues. By following these three points, you will be able to return to the heavenly home.
现在，让我们来简单地介绍一下三宝。
Now, Let us briefly introduce the three treasures.
第一宝，玄关窍，灵性进出的门户。
The first treasure, heavenly portal, the main gate to our true nature / true self.
在庄严神圣的修道仪式中，便传师在我们的玄关窍这么一点，点燃了自信之光明，当下玄关窍立刻现出了如同绿豆大小般之佛光。我们可以看一下各宗教圣人的画像，每位圣人之头部都有一个光圈，此光乃是自信之光。借着后续的修行及行功立德，此佛光会逐渐扩大，最后就像各教圣人的光圈一样地光亮圆满，展现出来的智慧及德行随着因缘愿力而四处利益众生。
During the solemn and holy Tao receiving ceremony, Tao transmitting Master pointed at our heavenly portal to illuminate the light of our true nature. A small halo will radiate from the heavenly portal immediately afterwards.If we look at the portraits of the saints from different religions, we will see that they all have one thing in common, which is the halo behind each saint's head. The halo is the light emitted from the true nature. The halo will expand in accordance with our cultivation and accumulation of merits and virtues.Eventually, our halos can be as round and bright as the halos of the saints. Then, the wisdom and virtue we exhibit will accompany our vows and affinities to benefit all mankind.
玄关是一个正门，也是修心的下手处。行住坐卧之中常收束身心，从玄关发出之念头都是正念，慈悲心、喜舍心、智慧心。心提心念在玄关，在用玄关去听、去看、去应对一切事物，便能与佛菩萨以心应心。
Heavenly portal is the main gate of our body. It is also the starting point for us to cultivate our heart. Every day we need to manage our mind and body properly. Each and every thought from the main gate is righteous because it is full of mercy, compassion, joy, giving, and wisdom.Focus our mind slightly on the heavenly portal and use this focused attention to listen, look, and deal with everyday matters. Then, we can unify our heart with the heart of Buddha and Bodhisattvas.
我们求道是了解我们有的真主人，真主人也是住在我们的家里面，每间房子都会有主人的房间，主人有主人该睡的地方，客人有客人该睡的地方，这不能错乱的。
Receiving Tao is to help us recognize the true master. Our body is like a house. Now,We know that this true master lives in our house. Every house has a master bedroom. The master bedroom is the room where the master sleeps, and guests have to sleep in the guest rooms because only the master should sleep in the master bedroom. This arrangement should not be altered in any way.
各教经典也有关于玄关窍之论述。子曰，谁能出不由虎和莫由思道也，每个人要走出房子都要经由门户。的肉体犹如火宅，修行者欲跳脱此火宅之束缚，何不走这一条光明大道呢？
The classics, sutras, and scriptures of different religions all contain descriptions of the heavenly portal. Confucius said, who can go out without using the door, so why doesn't he anybody follow the way? Now everyone gets out of the house through the door.The physical body is like a burning house. A cultivator needs to take the correct and bright path in order to break free from the confinement of the burning house.
圣经里也提到
Testimonies of the heavenly portal can also be found in the Holy Bible.
眼睛就是身上的灯。
The light of the body is the eye.
你的眼睛若了亮，全身就光明。你的眼睛若昏花，全身就黑暗。你里头的光若黑暗了，那黑暗是何等大呢？
The lamp of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single,Thy whole body shall be full of light.
马太福音
Matthew 6:22 But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is the darkness?
马太福音
Matthew 6:23 The lamp of thy body is thine eye. When thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when it is evil, thy body also is full of darkness.
路加福音
Luke 11:34
你只有一只眼进入永生，强如有两只眼被丢在地狱的火里边。
It is good for thee, you, to enter into a life with one eye, rather than having two eyes to be cast into the hell of fire.
马太福音
Matthew 18:9
试问，是用左眼还是右眼上天堂进入永生呢？肉眼早晚会毁坏的，如何使人上天堂呢？
After reading the above verses, some questions may arise. For example, should we enter heaven and attain eternal life through the left eye or right eye, since the eyes of this physical body will deteriorate one day? How can they help us return to heaven?
玄关窍已被点开后，好好地修持，久而久之，身体内外真的会光明，连毛细孔都会发出光来，尤其是真修时练得到清闲闲，只是我们的肉眼看不到而已。点
Once the heavenly portal is opened, if we cultivate Tao sincerely for some period of time,Then both our internal and external body parts, including our pores, will be luminous. This is true for Tao members who have cultivated sincerely and truthfully. However, the light or halo emitted from the body cannot be seen with the naked eye.
佛经也提及，无有正法掩藏。涅槃妙心不立文字，教外别传点是问， 佛陀所言之正法是藏在左眼或右眼呢，或是第三之真理眼求获道的人就很清楚答案了。
In the Buddhist Sutra, Shakyamuni Buddha also said, There is the true Dharma in my eye, there is no form, there is no word for it.So where is the true Dharma hidden? Is it hidden inside the left eye or right eye? Or is this Dharma hidden inside the third eye, the eye of the truth? The answer is very clear for any Tao receiver.
儒家所说的君子圣其独也，指的也是我们的自性佛性是独一无二的，来自上天，要善加戒圣保护，莫让它受到污染。慎独的功夫，简单的说，就是存好心，说好话，做好事，以及诸恶莫作，众善奉行，精进永恒地向导前进。
In the Confucian classics,A noble person needs to be cautious with the one. The one is referring to our true nature or true self, which is unique and came from heaven. We need to be cautious by protecting it from pollution. In other words, we need to keep a good heart, say good words, and do good things.We need to do all good deeds continuously with all our efforts.
一个人若平日能够时常守玄，祥和之气自然会引发善因缘的发生。佛像尚未开光，佛没有被请入，拜他是没用的，那一尊佛不会接受。你本身就是一尊佛，要开光，要求道，求道就是开光，告知你真主人在哪里。
If a person can keep his mind focused on the heavenly portal constantly, then the peaceful energy emitted from him may attract or accumulate good affinities.A Buddha statue needs to be initiated so the spirit of the Buddha will be invited into the statue. Otherwise, it doesn't matter how often you worship the Buddha, he will not accept your worship. You, yourself, is a Buddha. Therefore,You need to be initiated by opening up the heavenly portal. How can the heavenly portal be opened? It can only be opened through the Tao receiving ceremony. Receiving Tao helps us to rediscover the location of our true master.
我们平常时候精神是外放，眼要看，耳要听，吃进去的营养也一直在消耗。守玄有助于减少营养与能量的消耗，同时让更多营养转为能量，运行于身体，让没落畅通，减少病痛，促进身体健康。
Every day a lot of our energies and spirits are wasted on the things we see with eyes, we hear with our ears.We think with our mind, etc. Thus, the nutrition for our bodies is constantly being used. When we calm down and focus on the heavenly portal, it helps to lower the energy and nutrition consumption of our bodies. At the same time, it helps to turn more nutrition into energy.Transport the energy throughout the entire body, and make the energy channels freer so that the energy can flow with less obstruction. If energy can flow freely, then we would not get sick so easily. As a result, our health would improve.
第二宝，口诀五字真言。
The second treasure, heavenly mantra, the five words.
念五字真言，不是外求净土，而是内生净土。口诀又名五字真言，口之修养也。口轻而诱人，骂人则口不轻，食浊者口不轻，言实以正有道也。
Reciting the heavenly mantra silently will lead us to the inner pure land within ourselves instead of the pure land on the outside. The heavenly mantra is also called the five words. It is used for the cultivation of the mouth. Benevolence is expressed through a pure mouth.If one curses and consumes impure food, then his mouth is considered to be foul. Therefore, if you say good words and consume pure food, then you can become one with Tao.
第一个字，无即无对待之真理世界一性佛性自性。真我二儒家中庸之天命之谓性，也就是说，我们都是老母的分灵，都是兄弟姐妹。
The first word means Wu Ji. It is the world of absolute truth with no opposites. It can be explained as one power true nature, Buddha nature, true self.2. In the doctrine of the mean, what heaven or heavenly matter confers is called true nature. In other words, our spirits came from heavenly matter. In this sense, we all are brothers and sisters because our spirits all came from the same origin.
第二个字，太极有阴阳相对待。诸如日夜、善恶、高矮等，也可以理解成一人心二儒家之率性之谓道人们的心思是错综复杂且迷惑的，因此需要依循着上天所赋予之纯善的天性走在正道上。
The second word means Taiji. It is the world of duality. Duality consists of having two opposites such as the sun and moon, day and night, good and bad, tall and short, etc. It can be explained as one power mind, three in the doctrine of the mean.In accordance with true nature is called the way Tao. The human mind is complex and often filled with confusions. Therefore, we need to follow the true nature from heaven and take the righteous path.
第三个字，黄极物质的现象世界，它不是永恒不变的。也可以理解成一人身二儒家中庸之修道之谓教。
The third word means Wangji. It is the world of physicality which is the one we live in. Nothing in this world is permanent. It can be explained as one power physical body, two in the doctrine of the mean.Cultivating the way Tao is called education.
要走在正道上，是需要有正确的教育与引导的点。
In order to be on the righteous path, we need to have the correct education and guidance.
庆心身是一贯的，庆在心思万己，生命万能，兴趣心思尽失，生命不动，一句此诗而已。
Our true nature, mind, and body are one. Without the true nature, our mind and body are useless.
第四个字是放出去，无所不在。
The fourth word means permeating. The greatness of our true nature can permeate the universe.
第五个字是收回来，回到玄关窍底。
The fifth word means contracting. Our true nature can contract and return to the heavenly portal.
我们的自信是无所不在的，而且自信是没有分别没有对待的，才称为无极。无到极点就是没有分别对待。
Our true nature is everywhere. It is absolute. It doesn't discriminate or judge. Thus, it is also known as Wuji, which means genuine emptiness.
弥勒也有慈爱之意，修行上让慈爱布满的宇宙，就如同老母及诸佛菩萨对众生的爱是没有空间的限制的。
The fourth and fifth words can be combined to mean mercy and loving kindness. As we cultivate, we learn to love all things in the universe with mercy and loving kindness, just like how Lao Mu, Heavenly Mater, Buddhas, and Bodhisattvas love all sentient beings without spatial limitations.
常念五字真言，你就与弥勒祖师济公活佛老师有感应，遇困难时感应就快，心不平静时默念五字真言，有问题时静不下来时默念五字真言，就有妙智慧。当念到一心不乱时，意志可穿越时空，直入佛之愿力之间，让能量发挥到极致。
By silently reciting the heavenly mantra often, you will create a strong bond with Maitreya Buddha and Jigon Living Buddha.Then come whenever you encounter some difficulties, Buddhas will get the signal more quickly. When you feel unease or disturbed, recite the heavenly mantra silently in your heart, then your great wisdom may arise to help you resolve any difficulty.And when you silently recite the heavenly mantra with full attention, your willpower can permeate through time and space, and enter the power of Buddha's vows. Then, the strength of the mantra will reach ultimate attainment.
孔老夫子说过，人莫见于流水，而见于止水。诚心专注一念诵五字真言，有助于内心的平静祥和，更清楚地看清自己，遇到事情时能做出更正确的判断与决定，并更有效地完成工作任务。
Confucius said, Men do not look into a running water as a mirror.But into still water. Silently reciting the heavenly mantra with sincerity and full attention helps to pacify our mind. As a result, we can see ourselves more clearly, make judgments and decisions more correctly, and complete daily tasks with more efficiency.
第三宝，和同学习宽恕。
The third treasure, heavenly hand sign learning to be forgive.
受报和同也意味着与仙佛和与仙佛同，把我们的佛心、自性、愿力和诸佛菩萨的佛心、自性、愿力相合在一起。我们和同修之间要和，才能同人与人之间要和，要同，就要学习树道，也就是己所不欲，勿施于人，学习宽恕，就像耶稣在十字架上所说的话，就是一种宽恕。人与人之间多一些体谅宽恕，才能和，才能同。若小同都无法做到，如何世界大同呢？四受应也是回天的一个凭证。
Holding the heavenly hand sign means to unify our true nature with Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. It is the unification of our true nature and bows with the true nature and bows of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Similarly, we need to unify with all people including other Dao members by getting along with them.We need to learn to be more cooperating, understanding, tolerating, and forgiving, so we can form a perfect union. Confucius said, Do not do unto others as you would not have others do unto you. The last words of Jesus Christ were also words of forgiveness.In order to form a perfect union with others, we have to be more understanding and forgiving. If we cannot form unity with the people in our society, how can we form unity with the rest of the world and achieve great harmony? The heavenly hand sign is also a token for returning to the heavenly home.
现在来探讨一下三宝的修持。
Now, let us examine further the practice of the three treasures.
三宝珍藏蕴含道统真传、天命真传、心法真传，这三样，每一样都很重要。
The three treasures encompass the true transmission based on the lineage of Tao and the mandate of heaven. It is the wordless heart-to-heart transmission. Each of the three treasures is equally important.
求道时，点传师点的右手点完玄关之后，会用左手在玄关前做一个附带的动作，此动作之意义为何呢？简单的说，左手的手掌心就像一面镜子，要我们用此自性之光向内照视自己，也就是一般所称之回光返照，自我省察，自我检视，也是修行的开始。
During the Dao receiving ceremony, Dao transmitting master pointed at our heavenly portal with his right hand and made a gesture of covering it up with his left hand. What does this gesture mean? Simply speaking, the left palm is a metaphor for a mirror.The gesture signifies the constant use of this mirror to examine our inner selves. Self-introspection and self-examination are the beginning steps of Dao cultivation.
每个人自身有个自性真主人在当家， 不是由眼、耳、鼻、舌、身、意六根产生之六种情境当家，也就是说，不被眼见之事物、耳听到之声音、鼻子所闻到之气味、舌头尝到之味道、身体所触摸到的东西及自身之起性来掌控我们。
Every single person has a true nature or true master who is in charge of the mind and body. We should not let the six perceptions produced by the six roots of sensation, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, body, and mind, be the master. In other words, we should not let what we see with our eyes,What we hear with our ears, what we smell with our nose, what we taste with our tongue, what we feel with our body, and what we think with our mind, be in control.
现代人生活过于忙碌，需要留点时间收收心。济公活佛老师慈悲说过，平时常守玄，祥和之气自然会引发善因缘的发生。为什么我们修道到最后，心性无法再提升？因为我们很少去反省自己，甚至从来不问问自己内心深处什么是我们的真正需求。舌摸是我们的根本，若不从根本上去下功夫，以为来佛堂听道听道理就是修道，心性当然无法提升。
Nowadays, everyone lives a very busy life, so we need to spare some time to relax and bring peace back into our mind.Our holy teacher, Jigong Living Buddha, mercifully said, in your daily life, you need to find a suitable time and place to focus on the heavenly portal and empty your thoughts. Then, the peace and harmony around you will attract good affinities.How come our mind hasn't even elevated even though we have cultivated for some time? It is because we seldom examine ourselves. We never introspect ourselves, try to figure out what our needs are, and what the root is. If we think doubt cultivation is merely coming to the temple and listening to the Tao lectures,then our mind could never be elevated. The reason is that we do not cultivate from the root.
光可以说是动植物的一个生命之源点和同代表一阴一阳融合在一起，正负阴阳磁场能相通。守道和同平日诚心敬意叩首礼拜。加上佛光的照耀及平日的勤功立德，对身心健康有莫大之助益。
Light can be recognized as the source of life for animals and plants. The heavenly hand sign symbolizes the combination of yin and yang and the connection between the positive and negative magnetic fields.When we hold the heavenly hand sign and pay respect to heaven and Buddhas wholeheartedly, the heavenly light will shine on us. This heavenly blessing and the daily accumulation of merits and virtues will benefit us greatly in every aspect.
修持三宝时，首先要做的就是自我的反省。然后向第一宝自信佛忏悔感恩。 生生世世以来，我们不断地在轮回，身口意不断造业，污染了自性佛，让其承担了罪业，不需忏悔，同时也因为自性的作用，割肉身得以勤功立德，利己利人，不需感恩于他。
When practicing the three treasures, the first thing we need to do is to truly introspect ourselves. Then, we need to sincerely repent and thank our true nature. We have been through many cycles of life and death. In every cycle, we created karma, good and bad.The bad karma we created had polluted our true nature. At the end of every cycle, we burdened our true nature with the sins we committed. Therefore, we need to repent for the mistakes and bad karma we created with our bodies. However,It is because of the possession of this physical body that we have the opportunity to accumulate merits and virtues and create good karma to benefit ourselves and others. Thus, we need to thank our true nature for guiding our physical body in doing these good deeds.
第二宝常默念五字真言，让心中的爱自然流露出来，爱自己，爱众生。第三宝，多包容宽恕别人。二六十中，无论身在何处，更要时时提醒自己，自己的心愿力要和仙佛菩萨的心愿力相合。
If you silently recite the second treasure, the heavenly mantra, often, then you will naturally love yourself and all sentient beings. If you use the third treasure often, then you will be reminded to be more tolerant and forgiving.Always remind yourself that you need to unify your heart and bowels with the heart and bowels of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
道场处处都是行功了愿的机会，要多行财施、法施、无畏施，度化更多众生返回不家乡。如此必得上天加批波转，不好的业力会逐渐消减，从此改变了命运。当然，当我们在布施或为上天办事时，目的并不在于希望能交换到上天的祝福，让自己得到什么好处。事实上，是因为我们的诚心敬意和无条件的付出感动了上天，继之而来的就是加诸在我们身上的恩典与波转，这是任何人都无法阻挡的。
There are many opportunities within the Tao society for one to accumulate merits and virtues.We need to seize every opportunity to help more people to return to the heavenly home by making some material contributions, truth sharing, and voluntary contributions. As a result, we will receive blessings from heaven. Then,We can change our bad fortunes and bad karma into good ones.So our destiny can be changed as well. We do not make material contributions or propagate Tao for the sake of our own benefits. If we do good deeds with sincerity and without asking for anything in return, then heaven will reward us. We will, then, receive grace and great help from heaven. These blessings will come naturally to us without hindrance.
从我们求告那一刻起，我们的姓名就已经登记在生命册上，成了上天的人。上天无时无刻没有不注意着我们，都在看着我们有没有在用三宝，是不是有什么事情需要济公活佛老师帮忙的。
From the moment we received Gao, our names had been registered in heaven. We had become the citizens of heaven. Therefore, heaven will continue to watch over us to see if we practice the three treasures or need help from Holy Teacher, Jigong Living Buddha.
现今人类的物质科技虽较以往进步，但幸福的指数并没有提升，而且灾劫越来越多，部分的原因在于人的负向思考与行为，自私与贪婪，造成价值观的扭曲与变相。有太多的人对未来都有着不乐观、不安定的感觉。面对着下一代的子孙，我们能留给他们什么呢？想要圣凡如意，就先问自己有没有众圣清凡。圣是就是上天所在办理的普度众生之事。凡事就是和我们的人相关之人间事。有句俗话说，你看重上天的事，上天也必定重视你的事点。
Technology and living conditions have improved tremendously in the 21st century, but the index of happiness hasn't risen at all. In addition,There is an increase of natural and man-made disasters. This is partly caused by humans' negative thinking and behaviors, greed, and selfishness. These thinking and behaviors twisted the values of our society. Therefore,There are a lot of people who are pessimistic and uncertain about the future. So what can we give to the next generation if we want our worldly and holy affairs, the work of heaven, to be smooth and successful? Then we need ask ourselves if we have prioritized our holy affairs over worldly affairs.Holy affairs are defined as activities of truth sharing and doubt propagation, and worldly affairs are defined as our day-to-day activities and matters. There is a saying, if you prioritize the work of heaven, heaven will prioritize your affairs as well.
愿大家能在三宝修持上多下功夫，守住自己的愿力，并实际付诸行动，本着真心佛性，借着的肉身来做佛事，共为三曹普渡而尽心尽力，众生将会因你而得救，你也因众生而成就。如此世界大同不再是个虚幻的名词，真正的和平必会来到的。
I hope everyone will make every effort to practice the three treasures, guard your vows, and put them into action. Remember to make good use of this physical body by following your true nature/Buddha nature.We can work together to help with the salvation of the three worlds. Because of your efforts, sentient beings can transcend the cycle of life and death. In return, you can succeed because of these sentient beings. Then, great harmony is not just an illusion. It will certainly be achieved.
感谢您，愿上帝赐福与您。
Thank you very much. God bless you.
是尊师傅的改革，啊，以及咱全民的栽培，啊，咱分会理事长的邀请，会当伫早起这个工作啊，来甲咱结缘，感到非常的荣幸。那么，伫这个课题内底啊，是我想要甲咱报告，就是有关于一贯道伊个内涵，甲信仰的好处是啥物呢？那么，在座各位。啊，虽然伫这个讲座来听，啊，咱这个录音带会流传去外口，啊，流传外口。那么伫这外口内底啊，对咱这讲座的这了解，可能无咱遐尼啊，做啊遐尼啊好啊嘞哈。那么因此，今仔日伫咱这个讲座的报告以外，以咱家己内涵知影，啊来介绍一寡互社会人士知影，所以。而且他的报告的课题就是信仰一贯道有的内涵甲好处是啥物事？那么关于一贯道到目前为止啊，也阁是予人感觉充满了神秘色彩的一个宗教信仰，非常神秘加神秘。感觉讲这个宗教到底是咧创啥？伊谈的是啥物物件？伊做的是啥物工作？感觉奇怪咧，有当时啊，佫足用诚心邀请人去看，有当时啊，佫袂互知影咧。所以，伫社会人啊，伫各位啊，有看到电视的人啊，应该会感觉这一贯道啊，感觉足神奇。但是，一贯道，互人会感觉啊，日本以来啊，几多十年来，咱对人间的误解，啊，佮政府的改进，这段真辛苦的路程啊，咱大家拢行过。这些一贯道，互人批评，互人指教。上好听的讲压两代，上歹听的讲天下正可咧败。啊，这是一贯道伫人间人误解正深的所在。但是各位，伫咱的政府，伫咱的民情，伫咱的风俗，是绝对无容忍讲下身裸体来拜拜，这无可能。尤其一贯道的道亲。真容易啊！去度人，度人就是讲带你的亲情啊、朋友，带你的爸爸妈妈来求道。咱来用另外一个角度来看吼，要做妈妈的绝对无讲头壳歹去带查某仔来遮吼，下心落去拜拜。这是上届一旦有那个证明讲，一贯都会向讲咱下心落去的大原因啊，就是因为咱咧传三宝传下的过程内底未使互看。袂用咧防灾呢，啊，所以人出去外口就甲咱风声，有啥物袂当看？啊，其实在热带以来啊，传法拢是秘密的，传法是秘传的，这是为家来。那么咱这个刀啊，有咱的坚韧，拢是为代表啊，啊，千辛万苦，从咱师尊师母的代表过来台湾办刀，啊，来传刀，啊，所以。就沾染着就讲大陆甲咱台湾的这个色彩，所以政府啊也甲咱禁止真久的时间。不过啊，沾着这个课啊，吼咱一贯都来对讲好这课，啊就沾着这个课吼也袂歹，啊那袂歹讲因何结合？因为久久啊吼，啊报纸就甲咱宣传，迄种唔免开广告去的。但是，对嘛吼，久久啊就甲咱报讲哦，啊这一贯都弄掠着啊。哎，一半拢爱几落万呢？ 即个咱保工建筑落成哦，敢那砍一半就要三十几万呢，啊，迄个咱砍几落间拢免钱，看咱历年来我赚偌济，你甲想看嘛？敢那赚这广告费赚不少。所以咱伫咧团队，咱伫幕后啊，非常的辛苦，伫咧做，目前有进入嘛？因为伊春节还是砍不做吼，咱也吃出名。虽然大家一滴半半盖讲这是一贯的，是鸭卵糕，是车轮路迄个办，迄拢无妨，迄甲咱的修行拢无关系。咱也是照常为二三十年以来修行修到这尼啊好，对社会嘛是热烈伫咧贡献啊。咱就因为报纸刊，因为人批评，因为人讲，啊，大家无了解，咱就无做，无啦。咱讲咱足认真伫咧做，这是咱爱认识的讲，一贯的伊哪有这尼啊多人咧信仰？一贯都伫这个社会扮演的角色，哪有遐多人认同？哦，那一般社会讲来讲信徒哪会遐多？只要拢是一贯都有内涵、有好处，大家才咧信。不过在座讲伊道亲，咱爱知影吼。咱一贯都以民国七十六年，就讲用政府立案了后，那么咱就以幕后走向幕前，这是哦。若敢讲食菜，若敢讲修行，爱讲较细声淡薄。咱若去无素食馆的所在食饭，啊，若要共买一饭买一菜，啊，讲啊，你咱安尼食，无啦，我食菜啊，甲食菜无啥共款。食菜啊较细，啊食菜较大，你知？吼，啊，即下咱拢讲食菜。啊，较早若人去做兵，还是去创啥？去倒位参加活动，讲你算啥？无啦，我都信佛教。啊，上古早拢嘛叫信道教，因为咱古早伫咱李世民经过上尊严大德啊，伊甲咱有参加道教会，所以上古早咱是道教，吼、哦，也未改变以前咱就挖过一层道教。所以后人讲咱是佛教，咱讲是道教，其实在拢毋是，咱嘛做一贯道。啊，咱今仔为无情，正向无后，正向无情，就向头前来推演，所以才有今仔日这个工作。伊人讲。透过这个龙眼大，希望透过咱这个工作，让咱的社会人士知影咱一贯道是啥物物件。但是在座各位，你一定要会记哦，你互社会肯定咱一贯道，你互社会知影咱一贯道有好处哦。上简单的一条路，上简单的一个速度，就是讲咱家己家己做啊好，咱家己家己修啊好，咱家己甲趣味做条，安尼甲斗啊好来，安尼吼，安尼就一贯道咧推动就紧啦。各位，工作的人，各位恁有看录影带的人，拢同款吼。可能你的厝边这边，拢有一贯道的地主，有一贯道的道亲。啊，你若听到道亲，看到道亲，讲哎呦，这个人都袂歹，有影人信好吼，修养袂歹。啊，你若一讲到唔甲人计较，烧麻冤家两句吼，伊讲啊，我看迄道吼，你讲什么一贯吼，一贯道吼，我看是差不多啦。无偌济啦，大家也办餐厅啦，人我无信别行，也无咧创啥，也无咧食菜吼，伊使用也袂比伊较差、啊，所以这个也可能一个误解吼，因为都是真忠哥，都是真智性的，唔过个人使用吼，也个有差别。所以我希望讲，咱的道亲拢在做吼，一定爱安那，家己本身修也好，啊，再甲厝边这边吼，啊下来。安尼这个道啊，才有法度以咱以无后正向无前的这个当下，人才会甲咱成立。所以咱三宝传下来，对咱讲这个合同安尼好啊，这个合同好在，或者圆满啊，或者家中合适，咱安尼嘛合适啦。不过咱这个合适是安那，伊就圆融包容。咱若袂晓圆融甲包容，那就一贯道，你安那向无后向无前，以无后向无前去推动，这是最要紧的。所以咱今嘛出门。咱爱谨记在心，哦，尤其咱若穿这衫衫吼，足新奇个，足奇怪，人会拢甲你问讲，啊，你是保险公司个哟，吼吼，啊，你是毋是保险公司个？讲我毋是咧，我讲做个上天个保险公司啦，上天个保险公司你知？因为咱求道有啥物好处？求道有好处就是讲会超生了死个道道下来嘛，即咱大家拢知啊。会让咱内心灵的内在得到解脱，会让咱这个身躯的本性完成灵魂解脱，或者超生了死。啊，会让咱的这个在世的灾劫灾难，会当透过咱的信仰、咱的精神老母娘、咱的本尊弥勒佛、咱的 真多人有敬仰的神，甲咱庇佑，甲咱化解。啊，透过安尼，咱若无做好，哇，啊就麻烦啦。哦，所以这个，咱人间唔知影，啊，咱大家爱来推动，应该家己做好上要紧。所以对于人间的误解也好，进入的改进也好，这几年来，咱大家拢对于毅力，毅力做。那个一点就是讲，咱最重视啊，最主要是日日经营啊，日日经营就是讲点点啊来做。对于咱啊，有去鼓励伊，有去养老伊，有去社会公益团队，咱也去捐钱，万家下一捐多呢。安怎你知影无？因惊你啊啦！我嘛唔敢啊，这是我嘛唔敢，我嘛写我的名，写公司的名，我嘛唔敢写一贯多单修炼，干遐好大，怎么写安尼？安尼良心就来抓去啦。但是政府改进了，咱社会进步，所以咱就公开来活动啊，公开活动做了足多工作，所以在座各位，咱诚心的捐献啊，咱也有伫社会做公益事业。一定要担着一贯道总会，一贯道总会，代表我们的团体，代表我们的道，代表咱的道，代表咱的团队，安尼才好做，真正立立根根啊，依据个啥，才好做整体性的观念，整体性的推动，那么才会当得到社会的认同，这是一个要再来做开头，但是各位唔通未记讲教。是咱的尊严，是咱的尊严代表啊，非常辛苦，从咱时阵所有的代表，为代表啊，为代表，以至个来台湾办桌，非常的辛酸苦涩，血汗换来的资金，咱爱来珍惜，啊，哪讲爱来珍惜呢？咱也无珍惜，社会人无甲咱认同，啊，咱的家庭无甲咱认同。咱的修道无人甲咱认同，各位，安尼做修这道啊，唔是一贯道，或者咱台语讲啊，叫高曲道啦，高曲道恁知无？修甲高曲高曲，啊无亲情，啊无朋友，吼，遐也无厝边，也无隔壁，啊，五十六十亲情，八十九十岁拢无啊，剩咱家一个安尼的时阵吼，那这就很麻烦了，哦，就真麻烦。咱一贯道是一个真宽容、真包容的宗教信仰。哦，希望讲咱安家来延伸到咱时阵时务的改变，延伸到咱前面的辛苦的迄个结晶。安尼咱向社会来讲，咱一贯都是好，人会肯定；咱向社会来讲，咱一贯都是赞的，人会甲咱认同。啊，那么安家咱好好来改珍惜，都是最要紧。那么再来就是讲，虽然咱是公开，虽然咱是。已经在社会啊，有淡薄啊，这个或者名望啊，尤其最近咱的道场啊，一直听到咱政府的修正种种来甲咱活动啊，哇，感觉名声真好。不过社会人士对一贯道的宗旨、甲伊的活动内容、甲伊传发的内涵，也是一知半解。真侪学者你甲讲一贯道，吼、哦，真侪学者你甲讲一贯道，伊讲哈。一贯道听说过，捌听过，啊！伊是咧创啥？哇！有当时啊，咱嘛才临时哦，像杨少唔知你安怎甲伊讲咧？讲一贯道是安怎？像杨要甲讲就讲一贯道是安怎吼？啊！照咱一贯道的宗旨安排啊嘛，该念互伊听，啊！敬天地，礼神明，讲修无，我念了后听伊讲，怪怪啊！你来信啊？这样啊？对。机械化啊，机制化啊，就是在希望讲今仔日借这个机会啊，借这个工作，借这个录音啊，会当咱啊，会当来讲讲咱一贯道的内涵是啥，讲讲咱一贯道对社会活动的经营是啥，讲讲咱一贯道伊伫咧传发的过程又是啥。啊，那么师兄也要来甲咱讲来讲一贯道的名称，一贯道名称按倒来。一贯道的名称啊，按两条线索来，两条线索。对文化传承来讲，文化传承来讲的话，伊是按孔子甲颜回啊，颜夫子的一个对话来。有一天孔夫子叫颜渊来啊，伊讲 我都一以贯之啊，这句话的速度真出名啊，时常互人一贯道弟子啊提起要讲的讲一贯道，一贯道就是我都一以贯之，但是这个是伫文化传承是对的，如果伫传统的传承内底啊，伊也有淡薄啊缺失。确实的所在就是讲，这几千年来，不是一贯都一直传落，是伫十六代祖才传落，都是伫文化传承上是对的，传法的传承上啊，还是有缺失。所以，有啊，有一代伫个一个宿州啊，专门就政务办的，就这个漳州啊，拄着王邦雄教授，他每一次伊就讲。伊讲足奇怪，一贯道地主来到我研究四柱这个条目啊，就提供我都一直关注这个地目来问我，啊，无就问讲刁民道十四可以安怎讲？伊讲足奇怪，这一贯道的这个信徒地主太啷安呢？这就是咱对这句话啊有一点观感。啊，这句话是不是成立？可以，如果后来都叫报告啊，讲就传承上或者啥，传承上或者。文化传承是合理的，但是传法上应该按个深入去了解，安尼才好去真正了解。那么这一贯道为倒位啊来？哦，为倒位啊传承？就是为十五代祖，哦，清末明初，哦，咱的这个民国初年甲清朝末年中间，咱的十五代祖王杰一，哦。咱一贯道传承内底十五代祖，十五代祖师王杰一，目前伫学界学界啊，对咱师尊师母无印象，因为咱师尊师母无地藏，没有著作书本呐、啊，没有书本经典流世，唯一有做地藏近代有关咱一贯道的经册啊，就是十五代祖师王杰一。伊拥有著《理所合解》《论语雅律》啊，《论语雅律》，啊，佫有一卷《探源》啊，《淡经录》，多书四十八份，即种种即典籍，和合解真认同。所以目前伫研究宗教的学者，若讲王杰伊讲理数何解是比较低的，伊讲一贯道啊，有真多理论会带伫即个所在。车的脚卡了，讲伊讲叫做站得住脚。那么伫一贯探源内底有讲一句话，讲武太宏三杰一贯。吴太皇三旗一贯，所以名好这一贯德，他是在传道。那么这吴太皇三绝一贯又是什么意思？吴太皇三绝一贯，就会当展现着咱佛堂的设备。哦，咱的佛堂设备对吧？咱的路边或者路脚边，咱的那边一边花边或者啥，或者太极边，对吧？哦，咱的这边这花边，或者去个抢天的边，啊，其实咱唔是要抢劫，或者皇劫，皇旗是皇帝的皇才对哈、哦。如果您以前有讲抢劫，都是讲唔对的，要改进，要改进。那么武太皇三劫就是武劫、太劫、皇劫，啊，来串这几会，串这几会或者一管。就是讲，咱这个道是安怎来？为天，为宇宙、宇宙一路来到人世间呢？这个一条金线贯穿落来，安怎就一贯道？要按这来理解，咱传法的过程就无瑕疵啊，就无弊病啊， 安尼社会啊，若要咱每个社会人士知影，尤其咱在座有看到录影带的人，要了解一贯道，一定爱为这个所在如此来了解伊的精神甲内涵性。那无极就是讲无极离天，啊，无极离天，即讲无形无相无声无头的所在。啊，那气天就是讲咱看得到这个看得到这气象界。哦，看得到这个咱要包括星球这东西，啊，红极的红极就是咱这个所在，地球的地方啊，宋朝理学家就把这个所在讲号做黄极，红极，啊，红极就是幽形幽象。那么为五极、太极、红极，会当来做成讲三极一贯，把理天、气天、象天安尼串联起来。就是讲，咱的本性，咱的本性哈、哦，来自理天无极，来到经过到气天，来到这个人世间的认识去。如果会当经过一贯道的认识看法，一个三宝了后，以这个方式来修持，会当安那，会当翻起入理，翻起把这个气病啊，把咱这个所感染到的气质这个物件拢来去除掉，咱的本性同款会当归于本位，或者。离天的世界，这是按这来做解释。那么以般道的理想来讲，以般道的理想来讲，咱是叫做天人合一，哦，五太行三个一贯啊，讲起来就是叫做天人合一。那么这个天人合一啊，是安怎讲？如果咱各位人有思考有想，咱即卖般道的精神啊。你家了解，啊，咱家写来就知影吼。这边属天的部分，这边属人的部分，各位有注意到无？哦，一边是天，一边是人。按安尼，刘太皇三杰，五杰逆天，咱的信仰就是咱中尊，有啥明明上帝、无量清虚、至尊至圣，三界十方万灵尊长。哦，咱也来，尤其来这个啊，这心理讲堂啊，我们都可以看到我们老母的全名啊，哪位的全名、全含含名就是明明上帝、无量清虚、至尊至圣、三界十方万灵尊长，这就是咱一贯道理讲的哪位，伊含义一只，所以为无极开始啊，这明明上帝啊，安尼咱感情或者哪位。我这老母啊，我拢定定安尼解释，各位可能捌听过。因为中国人对这个庙啊，非常的这个敬重。就咱出世来讲，咱先到妈妈的八肚来十个月，吼、哦，咱到爸爸八肚来十个月，所以对妈妈拢特别较亲切。啊，你个人是父权社会比较重吼、哦，所以因离婚啊种种吼，啊，甲大汉甲细汉哦，妈妈话不落话安尼，所以因为上帝啊，都是。因为上帝在天父哈，啊，咱的上帝在啥？老母，啊是共的啦，哦、是共的吼、哦，啊，所以真心切的代志哈，真心切，所以他们的上帝叫天父，啊，我们的上帝啊，叫老母，啊，其实在咱中国人有拜老母无？你看，中国人有拜上帝无？有啦哈，啊，恁不拜无？你是伫佛堂寺了在拜，恁以前不拜无？我讲以前不拜无，唔拜了，拜敢拜？安怎拜？啊、哦，拜天公，有人讲拜天公。啊，其实在咱中国人拜上帝吼，拜甲拢唔知乌地拜，乌地拜安怎拜？你知无？ 因为咱这次啊，咱中国社会啊是皇帝制度，你知无？皇帝制度就讲天主，啊，所以伫个咱的四柱内底讲斋戒沐浴，可以啊，属上帝，会当拜上帝。啊，你知影孔子以前是做大官，你知影无？伊啊对皇帝去拜上帝啊，会当有影斋戒沐浴，人间袂当拜，人间拜吼，哎呀，去拜天公。安怎讲？因为吼，咱的皇帝叫啥？天主，啊，天主拜上帝，安尼嘛才变拜天地安尼。天主拜上帝，安尼嘛才变拜天地安尼。啊，咱是天主的主人哦，咱变天仙，你知道？咱变天仙咧，啊，天仙拜天公就对啊。对啊，这理论是对啊，合理的啊，你慢慢啊等于思考，这是中国人来的所在啊。所以讲，对啊，老早咱就在拜老母，老早咱就在拜上帝，咱等于拜到明白，啊拜天公，对啊。啊，大家拢讲天公、上帝、王、大天公，那合理啦，那是自尊的主神嘛。啊，那理论的主神吼，绝对是上帝这一边的嘛。我见到伊就是按这个信仰执行，伊老母开始。但老母开始以来，咱伫这个所在就是要叫什么人来带咱进去？就是讲啊，电视镜头头前的这台剧啊，咱伫里头，咱大家拢认识啦。啊，贪嗔痴爱啊，尤其今仔文明社会啊，什么唔是对咱的？什么唔是予咱简单呢？放不开。那你要安那办？你要安那离开？你要安那怎样种啊？你拢爱透过办法的思虑，爱透过修持的功夫，爱透过一段时间的锻炼，安尼你唔只有法度真真正正讲，大家讲伫这个现代社会伫咧修行啊，来海干那去挂吧，啊，去困觉，去调息啊，啊去。也足好诶，啊！毋过心地正善良，修养修正良，啊，修行修正好，啊，对人嘛是安尼像古早和尚啊，古早迄个大师啊，你去度人救世同款。虽然咱是前世当差别无剃头，无像迄个在后安尼啊。啊，什么拢同款，什么心地拢同款，这就是一贯的行入人世间道德，啊，就完全拢多少个是物质。你包括的有什么原因？那么原因就是，主神的形式。那么今天你透过这个教堂，咱来介绍讲，伊的内涵是啥？为什么咱要用这尊？传统的佛家，弥勒佛像不是这尊，因为弥勒佛像是非常的庄严，跟咱普通的做弥勒佛像是正相反。但是咱要用这尊，这是不是咱选择的啊？不是咱一贯都把它选择出来。你这间伫宋朝以后一段时间，就拢用这尊代表。啊，就是在另外每一代来讲到这个课格，一贯都去三里，也要讲每个都说这个是什么代表代。每个说，那用这个图像来示现你这间，就是讲以后我的地主爱像我安尼来修。以后要做我的地主的人，你就要像我安尼，像我安那看我，看我这尊像，你就知影我安那修。你看释迦牟尼，你就知影你爱安那修。他妈爱来遮做修，爱苦修，爱无无到三界，你大家去拢看现现。哦，爱怎样点点做？哦，爱修行，爱贪哦。啊，咱每日会唔是啊？无贪吗？哦，啊笑笑笑。啊！你看伊那衫是毋是无钱，通买去买开布救水去？啊！你洗三摆连救水也穿袂落安尼，毋是救水的啦。即阵佛像吼，头啊无头毛的意思就是讲，咱伫现代这个社会，你修行同款爱无烦恼，爱修到什么程度？爱修到无烦恼。即古早人讲，即头毛叫三尊烦恼死啦。伊讲你看我，你看我无烦恼，你甲看。啊，你去做我的地主，哪会使烦恼？安达无，讲伊安知无？安尼我看请伊家主事的人去请着剃头师傅来，但系拢爱剃头。我讲足奇怪，你知影吼？足奇怪吼！咱释迦牟尼佛上无剃头，你知无？无剃分的，啊，因的地主拢剃头。 啊，咱每个祖师无头毛，咱是个地主拢来海干啦。你们就拢吃到一点头干，嗯，这奇怪。啊，其实佛像就是让我们开悟嘛，佛像佛像就让咱开悟嘛，对不？啊，所以希望讲咱要怎样？啊，过来，伫这个现代社会，代志足多，哦，交别计较。对起一世人实在无三十个人啦，实在无三十个朋友。对起是砖头哦，一世人若无出这个砖头哦，实在无三十个朋友。今仔吼，一个月交新朋友交三四十个，一世人吼实在几落千个，而这个人数，你看你人中，咱秘密顶跟人讲话嘛，一定爱笑。你讲你要修道，要出门，要跟人计较，爱笑，爱满面笑容。啊，人要无烦恼，要有笑容啊，安怎？爱心胸坦白。所以，一贯道的弟子修持的，就是心胸坦白。心胸坦白，还佫无够，你知无？爱佫安怎？爱佫度量宽大。伊讲，你看我巴肚拢看会到，好无？即还佫度大，佫体贴，心胸大，坦白，度量大。哦，啊，度量大，爱佫安怎？爱佫会晓用。有翘脚无？你看有翘脚无？有啦，那也没有，翘一卡脚那也没有，那就是连翘一卡脚都没有。哦，一卡翘卡，啊一卡反对，那什么意思？你知无？行也爱修，用也爱用啦，唔通个无用啦。啊，你有注意无？那翘卡爱挂佛珠，啊佫提布袋，你有看到无？提佛珠什么意思？挂布袋什么意思？行爱修，钱也爱赚啦。你听啊，你知无？嗯，咱这罐头地主，咱嘛家己赚，家己吃，啊，家己做，啊，员工了，员工吃，家己添有利啊。所以，伫这个社会，一罐头之所以用肯定，就是因咱拢牺牲方面啊。这大社会，咱是咱自己讲，咱有钱家己吃饭家己，啊去做别人的工作啊。哦，去到处工作就是安尼嘛。啊，所以你家看讲，伊这个咱的努力去的和尚，安一路来，互咱感觉到是啥？无烦恼。真笑容，心胸坦白，度量宽大，哦，人感觉真用。不过，刀嘛要收，钱嘛要赚，对不？哎呦，对，跟咱现实做，咱做业地主，拢相像就对了，完全同款。这也是天人合一。你若做出来，明确跟实现，就是一路对科技、对社会无代价，同款在这个社会伫咧斗争。但是，你的事业安怎经营拢无要紧，你安怎做拢无要紧。但是你都爱修，你才会当超生了事。对，咱足侪企业家嘛，哦，大家嘛，即大家拢知影，长荣航空的董事长张荣花典传师，你拢大家拢知，也够足侪也念不完啦。哦，这是个代表性企业家，更有更难入正气的董事长啊，姚伟宁老董事长嘛是咱的典传师啊，这种大企业啊。啊，因那会听起先方面，就是伊对一贯道的含不了解，所以各位祖师来，啊，就话好师尊，咱讲话对老师，啊，有如意菩萨，这是天的部分，啊，天的部分则教予人，教予咱师尊师父，哦，啊，各位恁即摆就感觉奇怪，咱讲啊，咱要拜拜，咱会拜遐济，哦，咱有拜英灵上帝，啊，有拜咱的话好师尊如意菩萨，有拜咱的师尊师父，有拜咱的自具祖先。这就是一贯道啊！对天、对人、对祖先庄敬的所在。那么安尼，咱按只天啊，专门人，所以咱的师尊师父来传道。师尊师父一个人未当传全世界，只好真人来代表来传道，和咱的典传师来代表来传道，叫做天人合一啊！天人合一。那么按这天人合一的理想，为五太极啊、五太行三极一贯的理念来。由人来这人世间修善道，来这人世间外练，来这是人世间得到了，会当透过咱祖师的心法，安那得到超生了死的门路，安尼登去无极彼天，或者三界一贯。啊，这也是人世间吼理想带动世界人间净土的实现。假使各位，咱今仔来真正有法度，甲你着祖师的心法体合的话。那么，咱也无烦恼啊，逐天笑笑笑，哦，心胸也坦白坦白啊，哦，度量也足大足大个，还佫赚有钱，还佫有修行。你看这人世间，怎着佫去倒位超生了死？我看大家拢挂袂歹哦，敢是安尼？ 对不？哦，这人世间老亲像咱每个做出这个非常的理想，我看哦，大家拢大拢大袂歹啦。哦，所以各位，这个人间净土的实现，是咱一贯都办到啊，最大的含着着。这点啊，是咱各位爱知影的。那么，介绍这个一贯都人生甲内涵以外，就要要甲咱报告的事情。就是讲，一贯都虽然是对政府公开，伊个组织运作是公开，唔过到目前为止，咱传授三宝的心法，也个是安那，也个是密团，也个是密团。所以，有看到咱这个录影带的真人代表，啊，有咱该做工作的这个真人，你的亲戚朋友，也是你家己，那也得求过多的。啊，也未过来，即道场参加咱个活动的人，应该道高来伊来求道，道高来伊来敬道，道高来伊来第三步来理解，哦，来理解讲，即、這個、一贯道伊传法的内涵是安怎？因为即个规矩，即个佛规，即个真理，即也未当无讲，即阵在电视甲你讲讲的，你看甲电视讲讲的，你会成道未？如果在电视看到的第三步哪有效？安尼看电视，那咧煮饺无，迄副皮面吼，那咧煮菜吼，我看咱做来嘛会食个啊。所以吼、哦，伫电视看到的，多伫录影带看到的，传道的方式，就是即样三宝甲你讲，你若无得着老师师尊师母心法的传授，安尼同款无效，就等于讲伫电视看到炒菜在食个同款。所以希望讲咱透过这个介绍。让咱大家理解讲一贯道是啥物货。如果你要了解一贯道，你应该来求道。有你的亲戚朋友来鼓励讲啊，某人啊，我找你来拜拜，你就甲问讲啊，要拜啥？伊若讲求一贯道，求第三果，你吼半年半空去当的，你就要参与去啦。因为这是一个机会，这是一个超生了死的机会，这是一个修行的机会，这是一个成仙成佛成功了愿的机会。千万吼唔通去丢毒丢鱼不管。所以失去了很大的机会、所以以传道三宝心法就是得到观觉印，观觉印给你指点有很多好处刚才就说了，说为内在心灵的解脱，只要你得到道了，你有很多执着，你很多东西，你很多想法，你都会不固执，会放弃啊，这放弃更不是讲放弃事业家庭，佮对家庭的佮较照顾，事业的佮较认真，唔过你心理吼、哦、真健全，这就是一贯道传法的过程，互咱得到三宝的好处。各位，咱人若要跋落楼梯啊，上要紧的爱有啥？爱有啥？咱人若安尼楼梯出落上要紧的，你会去啥？或者气息啦，对不？气息就讲，哎呦，摸一个什么物件，安尼摸会掉吼，哎呦，家财无跋了。啊，咱这个人生的过程内底有啥物情节？我请问咱各位，情节就是讲出大事，赶紧来找人来帮忙；出大事，赶紧来找人安怎？各位拢袂赴啊！平常时若唔烧香，临时抱卡拢无效。临时若无甲人交陪，讲你做啥物工作，我看也无法度。所以，求道伊就是亲像讲咱人生的方向内底一个情节。在咱人生方向的一个指标，在咱心灵解脱的一个重点，所以观觉印啊，指引着咱灵魂的思索，指引咱修道的方针，指引咱皈依佛，咱弥勒佛的宗旨。在咱传法内底有传五字真经，这五字真经啊是非常非常的伟大，所以若有得到讲到头就知影，无得到想到头甲半去嘛唔知。哦，你若无爱信，我写互你看来。这里你带落，较大声。这里你带落，啊，这里的，啊，这两里你带落，啊，遐齐。啊，这个无理真经啊，所以一贯都传就是传无理真经啊。啊，是不是有你无你，你来求道才会知。你无来求，即世人唔知啊。我无骗你，啊，你若无来求道，即世人你了解即五字吼，日本来讲马达啦，有较恶淡薄啦。但是你若有求道， 这五字绝对解，百分之百解。啊，这五字是什么意思？足简单嘞，足简单。咱中国人吼，你讲上大的吼，大大你知无？上大的皇帝，啊，皇帝因老爸安怎讲？我叫太上皇嘛。啊，皇帝因老母话做啥？太后嘛。啊，皇帝因囝做啥？太子嘛，对不？啊，所以你把这五字甲斗起来，安尼来拍考，对无上伟大的佛名列，无上伟大的佛名列。但是这个传法过程内底啊，咱来知影讲，得到这个心法，咱就得到大智归依处，咱会当从此归依弥勒佛。哦，无经过咱就去等发心发愿，啊，咱就会当安怎？咱就会当得到祖师的摄受解脱，或者将来超生了世。啊，大师呢会当度人来求道，跟弥勒佛结缘，或者功德无量。想讲你今仔日来求道了，啊！你顿时赶紧带你的朋友亲戚，你甲这个好处讲予伊听，啊！带来甲咱们弥勒祖师结缘，安尼嘛是功德无量。第三，透过咱的总会组织，透过咱对政府和咱的认同，帮忙社会福利，这古早人讲叫布施，布施嘛功德无量。啊！就这拢甲加加起来，就这拢甲加加起来，你的灵魂、你的灵性、你的元神会当超生了世。假装咱家家家上在功德无量，伊会当安那成仙成佛都有教，主要在一贯道啊一传下来，最重要的核心啊，也是伫个三宝，也是伫个这个功能，或者灵魂超生了去成仙做佛，在生布施修行，啊，这种种甲伊种做就好在，或者人间净土实现。主要就是讲，咱今仔日对一贯道传播内涵的好处。啊，咱来台啊，来讲。啊，求道有啥物条件？无啥物条件。求道十条大愿，哦，伫咱的佛前十条大愿，即个入愿，唔是个救度，哦，或者十条大愿。这十条大愿就是讲，你从今以后，你好好来修道，你好好来帮忙人，安尼尔。无啥物啥物经营讲，我一定爱安怎安怎，爱抛妻离子，爱放下家庭，爱放下事业，绝对无。免惊，你来来。明仔载叫家，明仔载叫做啊，恁正赶快叫伊爸爸吼，不要紧吼，啊，拢不要紧的，迄拢无代志的。啊，十条大愿你就只会当传法，啊，那无你人钱吼，贴在人顶关，对不起，你绝对无机会好求到，绝对没机会求到，这是一定的。希望咱各位爱怎样了解吼，这是传法来的一个规矩啊，我天律律法啦是袂当改变的吼。那么一贯都。你嚟来求道，除了十条大愿以外，就受着要求，讲身家清德、品行端正，如此而已尔。哦，啊，有者功德费啊，功德费就是讲，出一丝仔钱啊，来应善主，来帮忙人，许就头一摆功德费，第二摆就无咯，唔免咯。这就是求道入门的条件。那么一贯道温馨，互相称呼或者道亲，哦，做道亲，啊，对相称呼或者。尊贤对后面留学生哦，或者先生小姐哦，安尼称呼啊，咱哦无像道家讲拄着讲啊陈道长哦，咱哦道家或者道长啊，咱也无讲或者道友，有足侪无了解一贯道的人拄着讲啊，原来咱也是道友。哦，啊，我心肝内拢想讲，迄死道友免去听道啊，喏，迄个道友，我听到就足快咧。哦，迄就来叫做道亲啦。所以咱老听到讲啊，这嘛是阮的道亲，阮的尊贤，这大上啊，拢是一贯道的尊贤，拢是一贯道的道亲。哦，啊，这点嘛讲予咱了解。啊，伊的信仰传法就是三宝心法，拄只另外报过观觉用三宝。啊，这五字你若要了解，请你来求道，你就知啊。哦，甲你卖关子一个啦。哦，啊，这咱的修行就是主张讲无禅定，唔免坐禅，唔免透过什么外念，啊，唔免断掉人世间的烦恼。只要你找十五有缘来修，你得了道，啊，得了道了，你找十五转来佛堂烧香拜拜，然后发挥有工作，啊，转来听道理修心养性，安就是咱的进步的目标。啊，一贯 阿公，心口什么叫做心口？心口就是讲话要足清楚想的，所以袂使讲字语，袂使讲歹话，袂使骂人，袂使讲热腔啊话迄款的，这叫做心口。啊，无若心口吼，若讲讲话啊，佫会使乌白讲的吼，按透早起洗嘴就是心口啊。但是恁早起有心口无？有无？无心口嘴就臭臭啊咧，哦，对无？是不是安尼？所以清口就讲讲出来，爱清，家里就爱清。哎，因为咱每日做事，伫佛经也好，伫任何一本经书讲，每日诸尊啊，将来不食众生肉，就是因为伊毋捌食过众生肉，所以一贯道的弟子，大部分啊，拢是清口素食。但是这是有一段时间研究了，才予家己自由。只是在咱的道场吼，嘛无大家食菜啦。嘛无大家食素食啦，所以嘛免惊，因为素食这个问题，啊唔敢来求道，唔敢来进步，安尼嘛无理想。那么一贯道以往生的净土是弥勒净土，伊唔是弥陀净土，有咱阿弥陀佛的，阿弥陀佛的净土无相像。阿弥陀佛的净土伊修持较严谨，较严谨啦吼，严谨就是讲爱足精进的，爱修得足好的。啊，弥勒净土。透过弥勒佛的摄修，透过咱的祖师的慈悲，透过咱祖师的弘度台湾，会当较好、较好，会当较紧。所以伊的净土目前为
三宝。
Me three treasures for new Tao receivers。
他人的一生中有许多值得庆贺的事情，但却有更多无价且必须要全力以赴来追求的东西。
There are many things in life worth celebrating. However, there are even more priceless things worth pursuing with all our efforts.
2500多年前，当释迦牟尼佛仍是王子时，亲眼目睹了人世间之生老病死。他告诉自己，一定要找到一条永恒之路。于是他放弃了王位及荣华富贵，四处去找寻名师及永久解脱的法门。后来燃灯古佛为他受记，最后他修成了正果，也留下了许多的经典，引导众生开悟正果。
About 2,500 years ago, when Sakyamuni Buddha was still a prince, he witnessed the four sufferings of life, birth, old age, sickness and death. He told himself, I've got to find a way that leads to eternity. Thus, he gave up his throne and fortune in search for an enlightening master and a way to eternal liberation. Later, he was initiated by Dipankara Buddha and eventually reached Buddhahood. Sakyamuni Buddha's teachings were collected by his disciples as sutras. The large collection of sutras have continued to guide sentient beings even till this day.
在一般人的思维里，极有价值，罕有，又很不容易得到的东西，而且是人类所一直在追求的，我们才会称之为宝。今天您在上天的恩典及诸佛菩萨的祝福下求了道，得了三宝。得道就是当初佛陀及无往经来的修行者宗教家倾毕生之力所追寻的永恒之路。过去因为天时未至，道是单传独授，得道者稀，修行者常有踏破铁鞋无觅处之 憾。如今上天慈悲大开普度，得道者众，求道者可说是得来全不费功夫。虽然得道容易，也是自己累世佛缘根基深厚，祖上有德所致，所以当您求完